Hey guys, so today I have another look for you guys that I'm like obsessed with, obviously. And this look is like really glam and sparkly and just sultry. And I actually did this look a few weeks ago and uploaded it on my Instagram. I just posted a picture of it and you guys wanted to see it so bad, so I decided that I was gonna film a tutorial on it. Do follow me on Instagram, it'll be right here. Follow. If you guys want to see other looks that I just post to Instagram and don't create tutorials on, because sometimes I'll create looks during the week, but I won't have time to film them, so I'll just post pictures on Instagram. So if you guys do want to see a tutorial on some of those looks, definitely comment something like do a tutorial, create a video, do something with it, so we can see how you did it. And I totally will for you guys. And I paired it with this red lip. I feel like I haven't done a red lip in a really long time, and I'm so like... I love red lips, and this one is really, really pretty. So I think that should be it. So if you guys want to stick around to see how I got this look, then just keep on watching. The first shadow that I'm going into is Anastasia Beverly Hills Eyeshadow in Custard. So with my Sigma E25 blending brush, I'm going to start running this shadow through my crease. This is going to be such a nice transition shade for that other shadow that I'm going to apply through my crease. I actually really like how the crease is going to be warm and my lid is going to be cool. I like to play around with cool tone and warm tone shadows like that. I'm then going into Anastasia Beverly Hills eyeshadow in Fudge. Now with a Sigma E25 brush again, I'm going to start running this shadow really close to my crease, and then I'm going to start blending it out. So I'm applying it in windshield wiper motions first, and then I'm going to start using circular motions to further blend out that shadow. And now I'm picking up Custard again, and I'm going to start running this at the very high point of that shadow on my crease, and I'm going to start blending out Fudge into Custard. I'm now going into Anastasia Beverly Hills eyeshadow in Truffle Glitter. So now with my Sigma E58 cream color brush, I'm going to start packing this shadow out on the outer corner first, stopping it right about here because I want to make sure to keep the middle empty, and then on the inner corner, stopping it right about there. And now I'm going to go in with my finger and pat that over the outer corner and inner corner. And that's just going to really make it intense and make all those glitter particles really pop. Now for the center of my lid, I'm picking up Anastasia Beverly Hills eyeshadow in Metal. And now I'm going to pack this shadow on in the center. And to really get that intense pop, I'm going to apply it with my finger. So now for my lower lash line, I'm going to pick up Custard first and just run this all over my lash line. And now I'm going to start running Fudge down here to really smoke this out. And then once I get towards the inner corner, I'm going to start bringing that inner corner down on an angle. And now I'm picking up Fudge on my Sigma E65 small angle brush. And I'm going to just line down here to really define it, and then sweep that down, smoke it out. And now for my favorite part, I'm picking up Metal on my E65 Sigma brush, and I'm just going to apply this right on that empty area and my inner tear duct. For my brow bone, I'm picking up Anastasia Beverly Hills eyeshadow in Blank, and now I'm just going to pop this shadow on the high point of my brow, and then just blend that out. I really like this shadow as a brow bone highlight. I think it's so pretty. It really cleans up the brow bone area if you went too high with your shadow. To line my waterline and tight line, I'm picking up Star Luxe Luxe Longwear Eye Pencil in Jet. And now the last thing I want to do is just line my waterline and tight line. What just happened with that? Also, all I did was just smoke out that liner just a little bit because it got on my lashes. So I just smoked it out, and that just gave it a really smoky effect on my lower lash line, which I actually really, really like. So all you do is just take your brush and just smoke it out down there, and that's it. So now I'm just going to apply some mascara and false lashes. And the lashes that I'm using are these Huda Beauty lashes in Scarlet. And I'll be right back to show you the finished look. And that's the eye look done. Moving on to lips now, so I'm going to do a red lip. I really, really wanted to do a red lip. I haven't done a red lip in a while, and I feel like this look is just so glam, and Yeah, so I really wanted to pair a red lip with it. I said red lip like so many times. So I'm first going to line my lips with the Almay lip liner in red. And then I'm going to fill them in with the NYX Cosmetics Liquid Suede lipstick in... What are you, my darling? Kitten Heels. It's an interesting name. So this is the NYX Cosmetics Liquid Suede Cream Lipstick in Kitten Heels. So I'm going to first line my lip. Is that a joke? Why? The thing just fell out of it. Okay. Well, I'm going to line my lips first. And now I'm going to go in and fill it in with the NYX Liquid Suede Cream Lipstick. So this is the finished look of my sparkly brown halo smoky eye paired with a red lip. I hope you guys enjoyed. I absolutely love how these titanium shadows on my lid have like such a nice sparkly effect that it looks like I have a sparkler on my lid, but I actually don't. I think it is so pretty. I love playing around with cool tone and warm tone shadows. The lid is very cool tone, but then my crease is warm. I don't know why, I just love doing that thing. It's so fun and different. Who'd said that we need to do just cool tone looks or just warm looks? You can combine them. So yeah, and I love this lip so much. I'm actually really surprised. I thought that this lipstick was going to be like really just glossy and not like a liquid lipstick at all, because it says cream lipstick, but it dried like a liquid lipstick, but it's not as dry as some formulas. It does transfer just a little bit, but it still feels like really, really nice on the lips. And it was a very nice like consistency and formula when I was applying it. And the shade and pigmentation and all that good stuff, you saw it was so pigmented and so pretty. My bangs, I'm about to chop them off because they are really bothering me. Yeah, so if you guys want to follow me on Snapchat, Instagram, and Twitter, that'd be right here, as well as down in the description box. And also a list of all the products that I used today will be down in the description box. And I think that should be it. So if you guys wanna do what? I don't know. But like this video, subscribe, and share this video. Let's get a lot of people to start seeing my channel. So that should be it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.